Very convenient, it's very simple. Very simple. Exodus 14 and 14 and 15 and Philippians 13 is where this is. Philippians 13 is where this is. Exodus 14 and 14 and 15 and Philippians 4 and 13. Let us stand in respect of God's word. But I'll read out that Exodus 14 and 14. 14th chapter of Exodus. The 14th and 15th verse, the first one. We're going to ask our sister here, Sister Len's daughter, to read Philippians 4, 13. After Brother Arnold. 14
and 4?
14 and 14.
And here.
Exodus 14, 14.
And also the 15th verse. Go ahead.
The Lord shall fight for you, mm-hmm. and ye shall hold your peace. Mm-hmm. And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore cries thou to me? Speak unto the children of Israel, that they go forth.
Okay, Philippians 4 and 13.
I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me.
I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. I was prepared to preach something else to be. And Rachel showed me something that kind of scared me in a whole different way. But it's still on where I was somewhat going, because the other message would probably take me an hour to get through it. But in short form, the subject for today, repeat after me, I can.
I can.
I will.
I will.
I must.
I must.
Grab your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
I can.
I can.
I will.
I will.
I must.
I must.
Father, by the name of Jesus, God, we ask you to bless your people, that they receive this word of life in a somewhat dead situation, a word of encouragement in the name of Jesus. God, send the anointing to make teaching and preaching easy. God, for we can't do it without you. God, move yourself out the way. God, bless this house. Bless the leader of this house in the name of Jesus and everyone that stands in the midst of your house. In Jesus' name, everybody say, amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. I can.
I can.
I will.
I will.
I must.
I must.
My first message that was prepared, I was going to speak on today, because God has been dealing with me after the homegoing of our bishop. I was sitting there, and he said, transition. Transition brings forth change. It brings, somebody said, change. It brings
change.
Forth change. And he was sitting there, and he was going over some things about transition. Going from an era to another era. Stepping out of one vision into another vision. And it's one thing that we realize that God is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And in transition, as we was praying about it, the songwriter said, without God, I can do nothing. Without God, I will fail. In transition and going from one era to another, man cannot go forward unless God is in the picture. You can't do anything when it comes to decision without God. Man's decision will always come to the point of I don't know. Because man will be confused when it comes to a difficult decision. Look at your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Have you talked to the Lord about it? We say every Sunday that trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding, and all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall do what? Direct thy path. Acknowledging him in not some of your ways, but acknowledging him in what? All your ways. Acknowledging him in all your ways. I had Brother Arnold read that first scripture because it was a situation that was taking place with Moses and the children of Israel coming out of a circumstance or situation. Someone must ask, what was the first service? The first sermon was from bondage to the promise. That was the sermon that was going to be, but it take too long to break it down. From bondage to the promise, transition from bondage to the promise. But sitting here in Exodus 14, chapter 14, verse and 15, verse, they're wondering what to do because they did not know what to do. So they're even going to Moses, asking Moses, where do we go from here? Hello, somebody. How many is ever, and you probably may be in that situation now, where it's so deep where you don't know which way to go. How many feel like that sometime? You're in the midst of a job situation. You don't know if you should look for another one or if you should just leave. Hello, somebody. In the midst of very, very, very deep situations, which you don't know which way to go. But I'm here to tell you that you need to seek God for an answer. Hallelujah. Sister Dick always said to me, if he don't bless you where you are, he'll bless you somewhere else. Talk to God about it. Hello, somebody. Because we say, Mother, greater is he that's within us than he that's in the world. But sometimes we forget about the greatness that's in us. Yes, yes. We forget about the greatness that's in us. But look at the neighbor, said neighbor, transition. For Exodus 14, chapter 14, the verse said, the Lord shall fight for what? Us. And ye shall do what? Hold your peace. Oh, he said something like that. For the songwriter said, if I hold my peace, Sister Eva, let the Lord fight my battle. Victory shall be mine, Sister Vic. But we're not holding our peace. We're trying to fight it ourselves. For the scripture also says, Sister Eva, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord. So if it's the Lord's battle, allow him to fight your battle. Hello, somebody. The question is, Deacon Porter, is there anything too hard for God? No.
No, it's not. No.
Oh, let me ask the question again, Sister Pam. Is there anything too hard for God? No.
No. No, 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 no.
Ye shall hold your peace.
Yes. Yes.
For it says in the 15th verse of the 14th chapter of Exodus, and the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore crieth unto me, speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, go forward.
Go forward.
Transition may be difficult.
Yeah.
The move may be difficult.
Yes.
But when you're serving a possible God in the midst of an impossible situation, it's not hard when you go to the Lord first. For the scripture says, seek ye the Lord.
Yes.
Hello, somebody. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, have you talked to God about it yet? Let me move on a little bit quicker here. Have you talked to God about it yet?
Right.
If you stop murmuring, complaining, all the situations and circumstances, and talk to God about it. Father, because there's nothing too hard for him, there's nothing too big and nothing too small. The problem is, Jamaica, we wait until things get difficult before we go to God and try to handle ourselves. But the scripture said, in all your ways acknowledge him, in all, not some of them, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he will give you the direction that you need. Somebody say transition.
Transition.
In the midst of transition, he'll give you the direction that you need. So we skip over to the scripture that the sister had read in Philippians 4 and 13 that says, I can do all things through who? Christ that does what?
Strengthen.
Oh, y'all read it yourself. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Back in Exodus, it may seem hard, Sister Pam, to go forward. Hello, somebody. But when you realize and recognize and not forget who God is, it will give you the strength to go through. Remember, your neighbor said, neighbor, your blessing is on the other side of this.
Blessing.
Go tell somebody, your blessing is on the other side of this.
Amen.
We have a problem. We have a problem with this that we're in the midst of. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. I can't feel my help now. We have a problem with it. This. So whatever we're in the midst of, we have a problem in the midst of this. Hello, somebody. Because transition and change is not easy at all times. Because in transitional change, certain things have to be rearranged. Hello, somebody up in here. Certain things have to be placed in a different place. My vision is not Sister Vic's vision, and Sister Vic's vision is not my vision, but it's one thing that we're both focused on. We're focused on a God, hallelujah, that cherishes vision. Hallelujah. Scripture says, I press towards the mark. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, press on, press on, press on. I press towards the mark, hallelujah. Now say, I can do all things through Christ. See, the same thing that you got to remember, that in transition, you can only do it through Christ. And the only way you can get through to the blessing is go through the trial. Hello, sir. That's the problem with us, sister. Definitely, we don't want to go through the trial, but the prize is on the other side of this. The blessing is on the other side of this. Hello, somebody. You got to take the Lord on with you everywhere you go, because you're going to need him. You're going to need him everywhere you go. Hallelujah. But Brother Ron, it seems like it's so rough. It seems like it's so tough. Well, my question here, Sister Vic, is, are you taking the Lord along with you, or are you trying to do it on your own? You can't do it by yourself. You can't do it by yourself. Decisions, decisions, decisions. We don't like making decisions. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. How many like moving from one house to another, huh? Hallelujah. Nobody likes moving, because you got to get everything together. Hallelujah. And when you get everything together, the second house is not like the first house, because Sister Pam, things are in different places. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. Especially if you're going to a bigger house. The kitchen's in a different place. The bathroom's in a different place. And some things from the old house do not fit in the new house. So you have to figure out how to organize the new house. Hello, somebody. You got to figure out how to put things in place. Well, you just can't fill up the trunk, Sister Vic, and go to the new house and think that everything that you had set up in the whole house is going to be set up right in the new house. Look at the neighbors and neighbor. Transition. There has to be, that's it right there. Be the part. There has to be a plan. Hallelujah. You can't do it by yourself. You got to take the Lord along with you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I can do all things through Christ,
yes,
that strengthens me.
Yes.
So therefore, we get to the topic at hand here, Brother Arnold. I can, I will, I must. I can, I will, I must. One thing that you got to realize, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Oh, it's quiet in here. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. You can't go through anything without faith to believe that God is going to do what? Take me through it, huh? You got to get in a place to believe, Sister Debbie, somebody. And in order to get into a place that you can do it, you got to believe in God and allow Him to work out the detail in the point that you can do it. The devil gonna say to you, Sister Jerry, that you can't do it. But you got to get into a place to have so much faith with God, Sister Lynn, that I can do it. When the devil says no, no, Sister Vic, God says what? Yes, why? Because I put myself in a place that I can do it. Hallelujah. And once you get it down in your spirit that I can do this because I have God on board, and I can do this because the same God that brought me out before is the same God that can do it again. Sister Kiana, you got to remember that God did it before. God is a God that can do it again. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I can. Once you keep that in your spirit and keep that in your mind that I can do it, why can't? That's the question right there, Sharon. Why can't I do it? Because I'm serving a God, hallelujah, that can do all things, that can handle all things, and that can take me through anything. Somebody give God praise right there. So I can do it. And not only having a faith to the big that I can do it, faith without works is dead. Look at the neighbor and say, neighbor, it's one thing to say I can do it, but you got to put the will factor in there. You got to put yourself in a place, not only that I can do it, but I will do it. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm not just going to stop at I can. I'm going to move toward I will. Look at somebody and say, I will do it. Hallelujah. You put the can factor with the will factor and say, I can, I will. But I must. Oh, y'all didn't hear that right there. Hallelujah. I must do it. I don't know about you. I know if I stay in the will of God, Sister Vic, I can make it to heaven. Hallelujah. If I stay in the will of God, Brother Paul, I will make it to heaven. With everything that's going on, Sharon, not only I can, and I will. I don't know about y'all, but with the Lord, I must, oh, y'all don't hear me, I must make it in hell, somebody. Maybe y'all want to be lost, but I don't desire to be lost. Hallelujah. I can't stay in the will of God if I want to stay in the will of God. Oh, that right there. I will stay in the will of God if I really want to stay in the will of God. And I must stay in the will of God if I want to make it in. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you must make it in. Look at somebody and say, you must make it in. Hallelujah. Come on, say, you must make it in. Go to three people and say, I need you. Go to three people and say, I need you to survive this thing. Hallelujah. I need you to make it in. To get to my kid, I need you to get to my will. I need you to get to my must. Somebody give God praise right there. The devil's telling some of y'all right now, you will not do it. Hallelujah. But how many know that you have authority in the tongue? Your voice carries authority. Hallelujah. The devil, the doctor probably told you, Sister Lynn, that you would not get up again. But you let that doctor know that I got faith in a healer. That I can, I will, and I must get up again. How many know that God is a God? I ain't praising up in here. How many know that God is a healer? Some of y'all get stuck in a situation that I can't do it. But the scripture keeps telling you that you can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Hallelujah. If you don't understand that, let me take it back, Deacon Porter. There was a story about a train trying to get up a hill. And first thing he had to do is get in his mind that I think I can. Oh, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I
You got to get it going to a second gear that said, I think I can, I will, I can. Hallelujah. And knowing that you got to get to the top of your mountain experience, not only I think I can, I will, but I must get to the prize that God has for me. Somebody give God praise right there. Until I get to where I got to get. Transition is hard, but it's nothing but a process that I have to go through to get to where I need to get. Somebody give some praise right there. I will. I must. Hallelujah. I must.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Glory.
I don't know about y'all.
Glory.
But in this place and time,
yes,
I don't see how anybody can live without the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I must. Stay rooted and stay grounded in Him. Build somebody. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other grounds is sinking sand. It's a reality check. When you see the pioneers of God fade away from the sea, as quickly and as fast as they are right now.
Amen.
It's a reality check when you see family members pass from the scene. The unexpected has now come to reality, and reality has taken place to the point that we need to really check ourselves and get ourselves together. Because I don't know about you, I'm getting myself together because I got some place to go. It's not guaranteed that I'll go from 50, Sister Porter, Sister Walker, Sister Brother Porter, that I'll go from 50 to 60. It's not guaranteed that I'll see the age of Sister Vic. It's not guaranteed. So therefore, if I don't have enough oil, Sister Vic, I better get enough oil. There's a sense of urgency. Young people, your time, it's not your time, it's God's time. When your time is up, it is up. You don't know how you're going to leave here. Some of you think that you're just going to die away old and fade away old. That's not what God is saying. Oh, y'all don't hear me up in here. God is speaking to the house. It's time out for plain church. Oh, y'all don't hear me up in here. It's quiet in here now. It's time out for playing with God. It's time out for using God as a puppet. Hello, somebody up in here. It's time to get it for real, for real, for real. Hallelujah. Because God is getting upset with the church. Oh, it's crying. Maybe I'm talking to the wrong folk. God is getting upset with the church. I hear it louder and louder. Being poured in my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and turn. From their wicked ways.
Yes.
I'm telling the sister on last night.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
When God has established grounds and marked His territory,
yes,
nothing else will be allowed to happen.
Lord help, Lord help, Lord help.
in his territory unless it's cursed of it or destroyed.
Jesus.
That hit me like a ton of bricks.
Yes.
Said on the phone last night, so sister, is nothing going to come up in those grounds. That's not in the will of God.
Yes, that's true. That's
right. He will curse it or destroy it. The enemy cannot even come up in these grounds.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Because they've been established by God.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, y'all gonna hear me up in here.
Yes. Yes.
For God speaking.
Yes.
Established by God.
Yes.
False teaching could not go up in this house. It will be cursed or destroyed.
Go ahead, tell it. Go ahead, tell it.
Hallelujah.
Just can't preach any kind of way. You can't baptize any kind of way.
No. Well, all right. Well, all right now. No. All right.
I wish I had some help right there.
Yeah.
I'm trying to hurry up, but let me say this. Your house should be the same way. It should be anointed and established in a place anything outside the will of God will be cursed or destroyed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
I just took a left turn right there.
Yes.
That memo just came from heaven right there. A lot of us are struggling with transition because we have not put ourselves in the right place with God. Why my children can't both change? Have you changed your house?
Yes. Amen.
Have you changed your territory?
Well, Lord.
Amen.
You can't allow God to be in this and then not allow God to be in that.
Well,
hello, somebody in the ear.
That's true.
Thank you, Jesus.
Preach. You got to stop saying, Lord, I can't do it. And he keeps saying, you can do it.
Yes.
But you keep saying, Lord, I can't do it.
Yes.
And he keeps saying, why can't you do it? I already told you to do it through me. Why can't you do it?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He's saying to some of us now, when are you going to ask me? When are you going to ask me for peace? When are you going to ask me for the answer? When are you going to ask me for deliverance?
Glory! Hallelujah, Lord.
He said, not ask. You ain't knocked yet. So how do you expect the door to be open for you to get in? For him to come in, and you ain't knocked yet. You got to establish I can first.
Yes.
Before you can get to an I will.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello, somebody up in here. For the I must can take place in your life.
Yes.
Everybody standing in here. Transition should not have to be hard.
No.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego knew that they have to go through a transition in order for deliverance to take place. The problem is, we're scared to jump in the furnace.